Number 96 on the list is Honky Tonk Women by the Rolling Stones. I was a bit surprised at this one because I couldn't recall the guitar solo from the song, and when I listened to it trying to learn it, I realized that's because it's really buried under there. Keith's rhythm part is way up in the mix, and there's some saxophones playing over it, but both Mick Taylor, this was his first recording with the group, I believe, and Keith Richards both just overdubbed some lead parts where they just kind of noodle around for the whole song. So there is like a section where a guitar solo goes and Mick plays some stuff, but it's really low in the mix. It's very, very hard to hear. But there is some cool stuff in it, so let's take a listen to it.
Here we go.
So it comes in off of the chorus here, yeah? Sidetracked because some of the phrases land in odd spots. Seems like he might have lost track of it. I don't know. But anyway, like I said, we start off the solo, and I'm just kind of noodling around there, which is what they were doing on that track. Up in the 12th position here, E minor pentatonic, on that gimme, gimme, gimme the honky tonk blues. Okay. But what I'm doing is I'm aiming for that G note at the 12th fret to land right on the bar. So after that, we have this phrase. Yeah, that's over the G chord. So G, and then we have this note. So 10th fret, bend it up, let it down, and then pull off to the 8th fret. That's on the 2nd string. Okay, then 8, 9 on 2 and 3. Then 8, 10, 8. Okay, on the 2nd string again. Then we're on to the C chord. Right there, we're sliding up to the E note, 9th fret, 3rd string, and then hitting the G note, 8th fret, 2nd string. Twice. And then, grab that F note, 10th fret, 3rd string, bending it a whole step, and then grabbing the B flat note, 11th fret, 2nd string, two times also. Then we got this phrase, which comes in right off of 1, not on 1, on the end of 1. Okay? That's over G chord. So we down in kind of a G minor pentatonic spot in the third position, starting on the 5th fret of the 3rd string, bend it, and then jump over the 6th fret 2nd string, and then 5 to 3 on the 3rd with a pull-off, then 5 on the 4th string, and then back up to the 3 on the 3rd string. Okay? Then over the A chord, we're doing a little, the same riff almost, same little lick, only in an F sharp minor pentatonic box at the 2nd fret. Okay? But it's got a little bit of a triplet in there. Just listen to the difference here. There's the first one, and then the next one. Yeah? Yeah, you let the bend down. Okay? Then we wait a couple bars. This is or a couple beats. So we wait all the way until the end of 2 over the D chord. Which is a cool thing. That's just bending the 5th fret of the 2nd string up a whole step. Not quite a whole step, actually. It's like that blues 3rd. And grabbing the A on the 5th fret of the 2nd string, then letting that other bend down, landing on the D. Okay? Then we wait until the end of 3. Yeah? We're going into a G chord. Yeah? So we pre-bend it to the B. 10th fret, 2nd string. So we hit play it 3 times, twice off beat, and then right on the beat. Okay? Let it down, go to 8, 9, 8, 10. Yeah? And then? Right there, pretty much the same as the beginning. Then? Yeah? pretty much the same as the first time I went to the C chord, except instead of this guy, we're doing this little. So we go 9 to 8 on the 3rd, 2nd string. And then we slide down to the 7 on the 3rd string. Pull off the 5, 7 on the 4th string, 5 on the 3rd string, 7 on the 4th string, yeah? Okay? Then we have a couple beats that we're waiting, and we have this little thing. Right there. So that's 3, 1 on the 1st string, then 3, 0 on the 2nd string. Then we do double stops, 3, 3. Yeah, 1st string, 2nd string, then 5, 3. 1st string, 2nd string, then little simple little lick there. Just grabbing that A note on the 5th fret, 1st string, bending it, letting it down. Pull off to the G note, 3rd string, fret, 1st string. Then hit that E note, 5th fret, 2nd string. Do it again. But stop on the G. Yeah? And then we're jumping back up to the 12th position to noodle away on our way into the chorus again. It's a That's it. Yeah, so here, I'll go ahead and do it again. Let's see. So, there's noodling away.